It's Don Kaufman. You are watching the TheoTrade evening video for March 4th, 2020. 17 minutes to go to the cash close with the S&P futures again up a ripping 4%. But I'll tell you what, normally I'm infatuated with percentage moves. You know, we've seen a lot of 3, 4, even 5% moves as of late. But this range from low to high, that's just awe-inspiring when you're seeing on a day-to-day basis 100, 150, even 200 plus point ranges in those S&P futures. Awe-inspiring or possibly a little bit intimidating. But what I want to do on this evening's video is bring to you, I think, the question that a lot of people are kind of asking here. So we've seen quite the little rebound in the marketplace. In fact, if I open up a 30-day 1 hour, all right, that sell side activity kicked into high gear. What? We're almost 10 days into this volatility. We're on a wicked bounce back to the upside. And everybody, of course, asks themselves, is it safe to get back in the markets? You know, is it safe to get back in the water again? And I'm going to spend a little bit of time because I'll let you know right up front here, I would be extraordinarily careful at this point in time with some of the indicators that I'm about to show you on the screen. First and foremost, yeah, evidently we're ripping back to the upside, and there is very likely some real buy-side activity progressing in here. And there's also, there's no question, okay, that yeah, some of this is short covering. And I was explaining this kind of the other day in one of the evening videos. And that is, you know, the dynamic of the marketplace selling off. So the market selling off, okay, forces trading firms to actually get short some deltas. All right, so they get short some deltas. And sooner or later, they got to cover those deltas by doing what? Okay, buying them back. And you get these wicked pops back to the upside. All right, so after you start to see the pop back to the upside, then, all right, then we can actually see some real buyers start to step in and there's some buy side activity. But there are, again, just some blaring indications that right now you're not really safe. And I'm going to show them to you. Number one indication that kind of comes to mind has everything to do with correlation. Now, couple of different types of correlation. The one that I'm going to show you right here is everything to do with the S&P 100. Okay, what you're seeing here is just, I mean, it's as straightforward as it could be. The S&P 100, pretty much every single stock in the S&P 100 is up. Doesn't matter who you are, where you are. Correlation, an extraordinary correlation like this, okay, is indicative of volatility unto itself. That alone, okay, tells you that, well, you know what? It's not individual stocks driving the market right now. It's the market, meaning the S&P futures. And the S&P futures are the fastest dissemination of order flow in the marketplace. So for the most part, as those futures move, it's driving all of the stocks, okay, behind it. That is not construed as healthy. Again, not construed as healthy, okay, for the broader marketplace. And I like to reiterate that because this is when, again, you can kind of get taken for a little bit of a ride. Now, granted, yeah, some of these stocks, some of this marketplace has been beaten down. I mean, today you actually had the financials, and I'm going to actually cruise over to an intraday chart. The financial actually dipped into the negative side of this before ripping back to the upside. But the financials, okay, what really occurred in these financials is they got sucked up, okay, in what is termed statistical arbitrage. And that simply means, okay, that you had enough stocks trading to the upside. The force of arbitrage, and what arbitrage does is it moves the market as a whole, especially in degrees of volatility. The arbitrage as a whole actually dragged the XLF up, okay, lit it up, and up we go. And that's actually in a very large part what took the S&Ps to some highs. All right, so that's one of the areas, and again, this is not a good thing. It's actually disconcerting to see that. There's no sector rotation. It's everybody, OK, gets bought up at the exact same time. Yes, there's some bright spots in here and maybe a little bit of dark spots in there. But nevertheless, across the board, there's just buy side activity. It's because the futures market's up. The futures market's up because what it is trading firms. What are they doing? Covering some of the short positions. The next thing I want to bring to your attention, this is a big one. Take a look at the VVIX. That's the volatility of the volatility index. Now, if you've never looked at the VVIX, that's fine. Anything north of 110 is dangerous territory. Very dangerous territory. We've actually had almost a record number of days above 110. In fact, you could bring back the VVIX. Let's actually back this thing up. I don't care if we go 10 years on a daily. Okay, you're starting to see this is one of the more serious occurrences of volatility. All right. And again, this is the volatility of the volatility index. This is starting to really make a dent in the marketplace. In fact, you can go back quite some time here and you'll only see a couple of instances. Again, a couple of instances of volatility this high for this extended period of time. That is actually a correct reading back there. This is all the way back in 2015, the yuan. That's the Chinese currency kind of crisis. Nevertheless, okay, we remain in a high volatility stance. This is indicative of professionals are out there and they continue to hang on to their hedges. In fact, they're even continuing to hedge. Take a look at the VVIX on an intraday basis. It's down, but that doesn't exactly give me a warm and fuzzy feeling that it's been rallying back up to the 115 level throughout the course of today's trading session. Next on the docket, you got to look at the bond market. If you're ready to sound the all clear, right? If it's safe to get back in the water, how come the bonds are saying otherwise? And when I say the bonds are saying otherwise, the bonds have actually gone into Never Never Land. Okay, and I know everybody's like, it's because the Fed. The Fed did it to me. Listen, the last couple of times the Fed has actually cut, interest rates have actually gone up. Now, that's counterintuitive, but that's the reality of this business. Bonds, though, are still in a highly guarded position. In fact, when you look at the ZN, is slightly elevated on the trading session, and it's been rallying into today's cash close. All right. Next, let's actually come over to the SPX. In the SPX, okay, this might start to get a little bit, we're right on the edge, if you will, of an expected move. Now, for those of you that have kind of missed this, the expected move is based on the options market. Last week, we saw, for the most part, about a 7 standard deviation move. That's that little monkey right there. That's a 7 standard deviation move outside of the expected. This week, we have, okay, $182 expected move. Okay, that's plus or minus $182. That's what we're expecting. You see that right there and right there? Yeah, that's the expected move. And I'll tell you what, we already tagged it. You know what they called yesterday? Tuesday. By Tuesday, we already hit $182. And I want to show you, if you've never really gotten into expected move, I pretty much think you should at this point because it tagged the line and actually pulled back in off of it. So where are we right now? Coming into this cash close, which closes here in 10 minutes, we are just shy of 31, okay, 31.37. Now, can we get outside that expected move? Absolutely, unequivocally, yes. As I've been telling you, week in and week out, we've been cracking through the expected move. We're Mr. Toad's wild ride right now, and you better be aware that a crack outside the expected move, it's not what you think it is. Okay, it's not about like getting short when we hit the expected move. If we crack outside the expected move, all it's indicative of is a heck of a lot more volatility to come. What I want to close with this evening is I've also had the question, they're like, Don, the volatility is high. Well, it's getting crushed back a little bit today, but the volatility has been high. Should I run out and sell options premium? My answer to you, absolutely not. No way. I'm not selling options premium here. Not yet. Not ready. Why? Look no further than the expected moves. The marketplace itself is still moving. And I'll reiterate this again. The marketplace itself is still moving considerably more than implied volatility is paying you for. Okay. The prime example is this was a $182 expected move. If you had sold premium this week, I'm sorry. We're going to move more. Okay, than they expected. And we've been moving more than he expected. What? You got 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, 6, 7. This is about to be 8 weeks. 8 weeks in a row outside of the expected. We're getting to statistically insane levels. But I'll come back to our original theme, which is it safe to get back in the markets? Right now, okay, I hesitate. And I hesitate simply in respect to the fact, okay, that too many of the indicators that we look at on a day-to-day basis, both quantitative and qualitative, are still pointing to extreme levels of risk. Cracking outside the upside of the expected move people think is extraordinarily bullish has nothing to do with that. All it is a marketplace right now, okay, that is searching for efficiency and can't find it to save itself. At this point in time, don't sell premium. Be extraordinarily careful. We're still going to get whipsawed for the remainder of this week. Have a great evening, everybody. Bye-bye.